A lot of people have asked how to edit to the beat of music, and today I'm going to show you how to do that with Movavi. Now, I said in the last video that I was shocked at how accurate Movavi's audio waveforms were. And what I mean by that is the peaks in the audio track really represent exactly where the beat of the song is. This is super important when trying to edit a video to the beat because most of this will be done using your eyes, not your ears. This is some stock footage I found online and I'll be using different types to show you exactly what I mean. Once you find a piece of music that you want to use, you'll be able to see where the beats fall just by looking at the audio track. Movavi actually has a feature to detect audio beats if you have any trouble doing this, and it'll put markers right on your timeline as reference points. Now, you can also assign markers any place that you see a beat where you want to use that as an edit point as well. There are different ways to make your footage move to the beat. One simple move is to find right where the beat hits, slice your footage, and then about 5 or 10 frames later, slice it again. Now take that slice, right-click on it, and you'll see your tools options. Let's click on Crop and Rotate, and we'll crop in on this segment of footage. That'll make it look like it's jumping to the beat. You can do this to as many beats as you like. You can also double left click on your footage and open up the video controls. Another effect you can try is to change the color of the slice. In this case, I'll remove the color and make it black and white so that pops out against the main footage. Here's another cool trick. Find an area in your footage that has a single shot, right click on your footage and click Insert Freeze Frame. That will take a snapshot of that frame and drop it right into the timeline. Let's drag it out and onto another track above. We'll slide it over to where one of our beats is, shorten it down to just a few frames, and it'll give us this really cool freeze frame effect right on the beat. You can even add effects to your freeze frames like panning in or out, or you can change the color of it as well. Let's try changing the hue on this one. Another cool trick you can do is stepping the crop in with each beat, or even rotating the footage slightly. The idea here is we're trying to change the visual pattern with the beat, so we'll find our beat, drop in a slice, and create our motion. Using transitions between some of the changes can really make things bounce to the music as well. Movavi has some really cool preset transitions that you can simply drag down into your timeline, put them wherever you want, and adjust them for how long you want them to last by clicking on that transition. The smear transition is one that I use in this video. It has a cool stretching effect that works really well for this beat. Speaking of beats, most songs have a specific time signature, so you can count how many beats you want your song to go before you change to a different piece of footage. The song I'm using today has an 8-beat measure, so every 8 beats I change to a different piece of footage. But any music can be cut to the beat, you just have to decide what works best for you. Remember, if there is any effect you don't like the look of for your edit, you can click on the star in the upper left corner of that footage and you have the option to delete each specific effect with one click. Once you get your footage bouncing just the way you want it to, save your project, export your video, and voila!